Here is the mystery solar system question dealing with light travel time. There's a good chance that you already know how to do this one, even if you don't know that you know it. You probably have experience in figuring out how long it takes to get places based on how fast you're traveling. In this question, we're doing the same thing, but the speeds and distances are much larger. Instead of figuring out how long it takes to drive to the beach, you'll be figuring out how long it takes a beam of light to travel to a distant planet. But mathematically, it's the same problem. We're going to follow the math worksheet and the steps covered on how to do word problems in the math online lecture. Remember that following these steps ensures that you've got all the information I'll be looking for in the assignment. The boxes labeled what you're trying to find and what you know are both the easiest and in some ways the most important parts of the worksheet. It's really the why are we doing this part of the question. For what you're trying to find, the easy answer is just the title of the question, the light travel time. This is often the case, but it's worth thinking a minute about what that actually means. Remember that your mystery solar system consists of a series of planets orbiting around a star similar to our own sun. Light from this star travels out to each of those planets, and that light is moving at a speed known as the speed of light. So what this question is asking you to do is find the time it takes a beam of light to travel from the star to some of those planets. That's what we call the light travel time. The what you know part is also based on what's in the question. Here is where you put in any important values the question tells you that could help you solve the problem. In this case, none of the numbers you need for the calculation are in the question. But there is one thing that could be helpful for your prediction. The fact that light takes 8.5 minutes to travel from the sun to the earth. So you should write that down in this box. Next, we do the prediction. Remember that there are two parts to any prediction. What you predicted and why. The why is important because without that, it's not really a prediction. It's just a wild guess. The time it takes light to travel from the star to any given planet will depend on how far away from the star each planet is. So you should look at the distance column of your mystery solar system table and decide which planet should have the longest light travel time. Also say why you picked that planet. You should also give an estimate of what this result should look like. Should it be just a few seconds? Should it be many years? Should it be something else? Here's where you can use the fact that it takes 8.5 minutes for light to travel from the sun to the earth. Remember that the distance from the sun to the earth is one astronomical unit. And astronomical units are the same units we use to list the distances on your table. So use this information to decide whether the time will be seconds, minutes, hours, days, or years. Note that you don't have to calculate how many seconds, minutes, etc. Just say which units would be most appropriate here. Also, be reasonable in your expectation. If you think the answer is going to be around 100,000 seconds, don't say seconds is your prediction. 100,000 seconds is really several days. Once you've done this, you've finished Part A of the assignment. Congratulations, you're well into the problem and you haven't even started calculating yet. The next two boxes will help us get ready to do the calculation. The first one is the equation we need to use to solve the problem. In this case, you've got that equation right in the question, so write it down here. T equals D divided by V. This means time equals distance divided by velocity. Since we're finding light travel times, we'll need to know how far the light is traveling and how fast it's going. The second box is where we put in the values we're going to use to solve the problem. We're looking for two sets of numbers here, the distances and the velocity. We already know where to find the distance. That's the distance column in your mystery solar system. So pick the three planets whose light travel time you want to calculate and put their distances in here. Remember to include the planet you predicted would have the longest light travel time back in Part A. Next, what are we going to use for the velocity? Here, the question gives us a hint. The beam of light travels at the speed of light. The speed of light is a universal constant, so you'll want to go look up the value. You can find the speed of light listed in lots of different sets of units, but I'm going to recommend you use kilometers per second. You'll see why in the next box.
Many students find this box the most challenging part of any calculation, so it's important to go through the steps we learned in the online lecture on math. First, we need to decide if a unit conversion is needed. Ask yourself, do all the mass units agree? Do all the distance units agree? Do all the time units agree? In this problem, we don't have any mass units, so we don't have to worry about that. But we do have time and distance units. The time comes up in the speed of light. This tells us that the answer will have the same units as the time units in the speed. Distance units come up in two places, the distance itself and the speed. Notice that they're expressed in different units. The speed of light has kilometers in it, while the distance is given in astronomical units. We must convert one into the other to make them match. Let's turn those AUs into kilometers. Look at the top right corner of your mystery solar system table and find where it says 1 AU equals 1.5 times 10 to the 8th kilometers. Remember that every conversion factor is a fraction, with the units you're trying to get to on the top and the units you're getting away from on the bottom. So our conversion factor in this case will be 1.5 times 10 to the 8th kilometers per, or divided by, 1 AU. This will be easiest to follow if we do an example. So let's look at a planet that has a distance of 9 astronomical units. We want to turn that into kilometers, so we multiply 9 AU by 1.5 times 10 to the 8th kilometers divided by 1 AU. We must cancel our units carefully to make sure that the right units come out in our answer. We get 1.35 times 10 to the 9th kilometers. Remember to stop and think about whether the answer makes sense. If it's several AU, it should be a bigger number than 1 AU, and that's what we're seeing here. The 10 to the 9th means this is a bigger number than 10 to the 8th, so the answer makes sense. In fact, the distance is just over a billion kilometers.
Now we can actually calculate the time it takes for light to travel to the planet. The first step is to rewrite the equation. This time, we put in the values for the distance and the velocity. Then we simply do what the equation tells us to do. Divide the distance by the velocity and get the time in seconds. Remember to be careful to put the exponents into your calculator the right way. Use the EE or EXP key and don't put in extra times tens. In this case, the time came out to 4,500 seconds. If you try this and you got something like 4.5 times 10 to the 16th seconds, then you're not putting the exponents into the calculator the right way. If you need to, try reviewing the online lecture on math, where we talk about how to work with exponents. Since 4,500 seconds seems like a lot, let's turn that into a more reasonable value by converting the time into minutes. When we do that, we see that this is 75 minutes, or an hour and a quarter. With your own mystery solar system, you should do this calculation for three different planets, including the one you predicted will have the longest light travel time. Finally, check to see if your answers match your predictions. Did the right planet have the longest light travel time? Did you predict the right units for the answer? There are three possibilities here. One is that everything matches up. In that case, you're done. Congratulations. Just write down that they match so I know that you did this step. Another possibility is that your calculations are fine, but your prediction was off. Don't just automatically assume this is the case if the answer disagrees. Make sure you understand why the answer is coming out the way it is. You should explain here what you should have said differently back in the prediction. But if you can now show that you understand what your prediction should have said, then you've got full credit on this problem anyways. You don't have to go back and change your prediction to get the points. The third possibility is that the answers don't agree and the problem is with the math itself. If you're getting an answer that just doesn't look right to you, then that probably means a math error, so you should go back and try redoing the calculations. Also, go through the example in this lecture and make sure you're agreeing with the answer we've got here. That will help you see if you're doing something wrong with the math. If you can't find the problem, you are always welcome to ask for help. Show us what you've done, and we'll be glad to help you get the question right. Most of the time, when someone tries to get these calculations and gets a wrong answer, the mistake is something very minor and easy to fix. So don't be afraid to ask when the numbers seem out of whack.